Welcome everyone to the first Coach's Corner with Iona College women's soccer head coach Sarah Brady. Sarah, thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Love to be here.
The first weekend's in the books. The Gaels are back in action. Unfortunately, a couple losses to start off the season, but a couple competitive games you guys started the season out with. Let's first off with that Bryant with the Holy Cross game. A 3-1 defeat, but you definitely saw some positives in that game for your team.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I loved it, to be honest. I think if you just look at results of games, 3-1 sounds like we were outplayed, you know, outmatched. Honestly, it was the best game. We went 2-0 down. Pretty much first half, we were, you know, on top. We had momentum. Didn't quite, you know, make it count. We're a young team, and we kind of paid for that naivety when we started the second half and Holy Cross very quickly put two goals away. But the response was unbelievable. I said to them, you know what, go for it. Go for it. Well, you know, I'd rather get beat 3-1 than 2-0. And they got back in the game at 2-1. And then at 2-1, we had some chances. So Mard at the post. Charlotte missed a header by about this much. Amber missed controls in the six-yard box. But they give it everything. It was a brilliant game. Swashbuckling is probably the word to use. But what they showed is they'll never give up on a game and they'll fight and they'll always try and win. I think that's something that we really need to get across in our culture. You can go 2-0 down, 3-0 down, you know, hopefully not much more than that. But you can always still win the game if you attempt to try and go for it.
Well, someone who went for it was Christine Rebus, a phenomenal goal off an assist from Charlotte Stewart. Talk a little bit about that goal and how it's set up.
I mean, the kid's pure quality. I mean, phenomenal goal, but I'm not surprised. I mean, the things the kid's capable of is unbelievable, really. I think that showed other people the quality she has, and she can just pull something out of nothing. But she doesn't surprise us. She does things like that a lot. I mean, and Charlotte's throwing, I mean, it's a crazy weapon, right? You don't see that too much. And, you know, we want to make sure that we utilise it, but we don't kind of rely on it. I think that's something that, I think if you listen to the commentary back from the Patriot League feed, they just talked about the throw-in. You know, we're much more than the throw-in. Charlotte's much more than the throw-in. So we want to make sure that we have it as a weapon in our arsenal, but it's not the only thing we have.
Junior Tiffany Martinez got the start and goal her first year at Iona. Talk about what led to her getting the start for the Gaels in this weekend.
You know, you need to address it as Mrs. President. That's her name, actually. It's not Tiffany anymore, it's Mrs. President.
Why is that the case?
So the team have basically decided that Tiffany should be the president of the world. Not just the country, the world. They adore the kids. I mean, she's a fabulous kid. We knew it when we were bringing her in, when we were recruiting her. You know, you always have high hopes for your recruits. Tiffany's my very first recruit. So, I mean, I was precious about it. I was excited about it. But then she gets here and she just lights up the room. I mean, everybody absolutely adores her. And you know what? She earned respect straight away because she was smashed the fitness test. You know, goalkeepers usually come in and they have to repeat things. But straight away, she's as high as the field players. The work ethic she's put in, everyone trusts her. Great kid all around. Fabulous goalkeeper, fabulous kid. She earned the starting spot. You know, so Kayla pushes her close every day. Kayla works really hard. And I think Tiffany is as good as she is at the minute because of Kayla. Because Kayla's not sitting back and being like, well, I'm not going to get a shot. She's really going for it. So, I mean, the big thing with Tiffany right now, she just has that experience. You know, she's a junior college national champion. You know, she's a junior. Kayla's a freshman. So Kayla's a good goalkeeper. She just has a bit more development in her. We actually have Abby back now as well, which is nice. Abby's come back from New Zealand. School starts today, so we've got Abby back. So there's a healthy competition with the goalkeepers. And we just hope Tiffany keeps pushing because, you know, the main thing is don't get complacent. You know, as fabulous as you are, we still need you to perform consistently.
So obviously some positive to get out of that Holy Cross game despite 3-1 loss. You guys go to Bryant on Sunday, fall 2-0. The first half was a little rough going. Bryant put the pressure on quite a bit. What did you see the struggles of the first half against Bryant?
I think it was definitely mentality and a little bit of fatigue, you know, a little bit of hangover from Friday because, I mean, they give everything Friday. Literally, when they come off the pitch, I asked a few players, could you have given anything more? And they said no. And I was like, that's all we can ask. You know, they were unlucky Friday, but they did give absolutely everything of themselves. So there was a little bit of fatigue going into Sunday. But the positive of that is we got a few more kids on the pitch who we typically, you know, would have said it's a bit early in the season yet. So a lot of people got an opportunity and some of them absolutely grabbed it and were fantastic. The first half was Bryant doing Bryant. Their pitch was the size of a postage stamp. To be honest with you, at the start of the game, I was like, I could touch the crossbar. I've never touched a crossbar in my life. I'm 5 foot. So I was jumping up. I was like, what's going on? Thought the goals were too small. I mean, they weren't. They were fine. It was just me kind of in my head. The pitch was crowned, so I think that's why I could touch the goalpost. But yeah, tight pitch, very long grass. And, you know, we want to play football. We want to play it round. And you know, they sat in a low block, and it was just kind of something we haven't come up against yet. And I think that shocked the girls, and we kind of succumbed to the way they wanted us to play. The response in the second half, you know, we had some fresh legs in there. As I said, we put some kids in who, you know, it's still early in their development, but we give them a shot. And we just said, look, play your game. They're going to do what they're going to do. It's not a surprise now. We've gone through it for 45 minutes. But go and stamp your identity on the game. And they did that much better in the second half.
Who are a couple of those players that came off the bench and kind of took advantage of getting those minutes and who kind of showed you something extra?
Yeah, so, I mean, we knew that Maddie had quality, our freshman centre-back. She's a Canadian kid. We knew she had quality. Just centre-back is one of those positions where it's very, you know, it's one of them. You need experience for it. You're always under pressure. And plus, she's got two, you know, upperclassmen in front of her in Emily, our captain, and Christine, who we've mentioned, two high-quality players. So, you know, Maddie just comes in every day and does everything she should do. She works really hard, she listens, and we give her that shot, and she was fantastic. You know, there was a few more freshmen who got to go. Little Trey got to go out wide. And JP came on. And JP, I think if anyone could be in your programme, if you could have 11 of them and clone them, you'd have 11 JPs because, I mean, Julia Pichetti for a full title. Mm-hmm. Just the most positive kid who just wants to give everything of herself for the team. Total team first mentality. Fabulous kid. I mean, she come in, she done the job. It wasn't just effort. She actually proved, oh, we can trust you to do this as well. You're not just all effort and enthusiasm. She used that to elevate her skill level. And, you know, she was very good when she came on. It was a pleasure to have her on there.
Well, you talk a lot about the players. Talk a little bit about yourself. It's your first time taking the field as a head coach, your first weekend going through a couple of Division I games as a head coach. How do you feel stepping out on the pitch?
To be honest with you, yeah, a couple of people were texting me like, oh, you're nervous. I was like, no, I'm really not, because I've always wanted to be in this position. The dream was to be a head coach, but Friday I was like, that's not the dream. The dream is to put these players out ready to compete. So you think, oh, head coach, brilliant. Dream's over. I mean, it was better because of the kids who I had out there. Like that starting 11, I'll remember forever. You know, I said to them before they went out, look, this is a very, very precious moment for me. I don't want to make this about me, but I just need you guys to, you know, to know. I wouldn't be going through this with 11 other people. I wouldn't choose this with 11 other people. You're the people who I'm just so proud of. And I really hope you walk off the pitch tonight proud of yourself. So we got a little bit emotional, but it was brilliant. I loved every minute of it.
All right, so at this week in practice, you guys are playing Columbia on Friday in the home opener at 4 o'clock here at Mazzella Field. What are you working on this week in practice to prepare for the Lions?
Columbia might be watching, I can't tell you. I'm
only kidding. Fair enough.
No, you know what? We want to be more strong in our identity. So when we feel like we're on top, we're completely in our identity. When we feel a little bit under the cosh, or when we feel like we're up against quality, or we're up against something we haven't quite seen, we tend to deviate, or we're not as strong in our identity as I would like to be. So this week's training is going to be, you know what, this is our identity. Let's really go for the game with this in mind. You know, Columbia's an Ivy League team. There's no tape on them. We haven't seen them. They basically start a little bit later than other Division I programs. So I was like, look, it's about us. If we do what we're supposed to do and we're mindful of what our job is on and off the ball, we can compete. And that's all we can ever ask them to do.
Well, Sarah, I want to thank you for joining us. But before we let you go, I got to ask you about those cleats behind you. You got a pair of pink cleats hanging up. What's the story behind those?
So these were actually mine. So before I have any jokes about, you know, they should be hanging off a car rear view mirror, they are pretty small, right? Size 3. So my favorite player of all time is a kid from Jersey called Niamh Gaffney. She must be about 13 now. I coached her when she was 9, 10, 11. At East Brunswick Soccer Club, which was, you know, one of my greatest coaching experiences. And these were my boots, and she turned up one day and she didn't have hair, so I said, can you wear the boots? And she wore them and she lit them up. So I couldn't wear them again because she made them look so much better than me. So I asked her to sign them for me. So I said to her, you know what, Niamh, you're my favourite player of all time. If one day I make it as a head coach, I'm going to have them boots up on the wall. So not quite the wall on the board, but they're up there. So, yeah, that's my favourite player of all time. Little magician. Could dribble through anything. She was fabulous.
Well, Sarah, that's a fantastic story. I want to thank you for joining us, and best of luck against Columbia this Friday.
Thank you. I appreciate it.